my god, my whole set is falling apart. No! I'm filming in the bathroom and the camera lid just fell in the toilet. Hey, I'm back. I'm not dead. What a surprise. So, I don't know if you noticed, it's been like over a month since I posted that first video. I've been sick. I still have bronchitis. And then I got sinusitis, and now I have to get x-rayed for pneumonia. So like, I'm doing real good, guys, if you were wondering at all, yeah. But at least I'm back with another video. You know, I'm fighting through it. I'm on four different medications, but I'm here, you know, like we're gonna do this. So today's video is gonna be a book haul slash sort of review on just two of the books that I have already read since I bought these books like 3 weeks ago now. I meant to do this video a while ago, guys. I'm sorry, okay? So the first book is The Tyrant's Daughter by J.C. Carleson? I actually don't know how to pronounce that. But yeah, it's actually super, super interesting. I think it's really important for something to read, like, nowadays. So this book is about a 15-year-old named Layla from an unnamed Middle Eastern country in which her father sort of ran, and they are now refugees living in, I forget where, Washington, D.C. So they are now living in the suburbs, and it's a 15-year-old with her little brother, and essentially the book is really talking about this girl's life now in the US compared to what it used to be in Middle Eastern. So seeing it from a child's perspective is just, it's been interesting so far. I've been like two chapters in and I like it so far. The second book is one I got in a sale that Indigo is having. Canada, what's up? It's called Thanks for the Trouble. So this book is about a guy named Parker who has not spoken a single word in 5 years, and a girl he meets called Zelda. I'm actually not too sure what else the book is about, I'm not gonna lie. I saw the big $6 on it, and then the cover, which is just so interesting. I don't know if you guys can see it, but like, you rarely see a photographic image with like so much happening on the cover. I don't know, I thought it was really cool, and like it keeps going on the back, and there's like the two coffee cups. Honestly, I judged this book by its cover. The next books are all books I bought in another sale because I'm cheap, but it was old classics, and they were actually cheaper than $6. I think all of these together were $10. So they're all sort of refurbished, I guess, covers, which are more modern and illustrative than the originals. So this one's Persuasion by Jane Austen. Classic, so I'm not gonna explain them. Then I also got Jane Eyre by Charlotte Brontë. Is that focused? I don't know, I hope. And I also got Northanger, Abbey by Jane Austen as well. You know, I was feeling that girl power. There was so many other books, but honestly, I was, even with the $10 sale, I was too broke to buy even more. Because I did buy these all together. I was trying to get as many as possible. The second I got is one I was actually really excited for. It's The Sun and Her Flowers by Rupi Kaur. I'm sorry, I'm butchering her name if it's not like that. And this is the second installment from, well, not second installment, it's her second published book. Her first was Milk and Honey was the first book that she wrote, and I really love that. So I'm really excited for this. I've heard good things so far, and it's a lot thicker than the first one, so I'm hoping I get a lot more content. So these next two books are books that I have already read, but were part of this haul. I just bought these books so long ago, like, it's been almost a month at this point. So the first book is Shooter, I'm covering the title, by Caroline Pignat, and I'm giving this a 3 out of 5 stars. This book is about a school shooter, and it's from the perspectives of 5 people that are all stuck in a bathroom together. So the topic is very dark, but the author sort of wrote it in a very lighthearted way, which is, it's confusing considering that like it's a school shooting. It's not necessarily like, I don't know. It's not something we normally like think about is lighthearted YA novel, but it was. I do think it's for a younger audience, not younger as in like a little kid, but definitely like tween and like young teens, just because of the format it's written. It does have sort of moments where it's text messages, like full chapters of just text messages, and a lot of the drama and just sort of the way it's written is very young. which is the only reason I gave it a 3 out of 5. But I think it was still good together. I was still upset, you know, at certain points in time. It did tug my heartstrings. It was well written, for sure. The second book is Textrovert by Lindsey Summers. I actually got this when I went to the Wattpad signing because my bomb-ass friend Kassandra Tate was there with her book for the Imagines by that. I'll put that in the link below. Love you, Kassandra. But yeah, I got this and she actually signed it for me. Where is it? Where are you? There it is. Thank you, Lindsey. You rock. She's super nice, honestly. So Lindsey is a Wattpad writer, and she did get a book published, which I think is so cool. I love people seeing, like, start on the internet, get published. Like, that's amazing. I'm so proud of her. And this was actually really, really good. I loved it. It was a 4 out of 5. Again, this was written, I think, for maybe a slightly younger crowd than myself at 20, but I still think, like, for that crowd, it was good. So this book is about Keely and Talon, who accidentally swap phones and sort of communicate in that way for a really long time, and it's a love story. It's really nice. I loved it. It was definitely a quick read because it is a lot smaller, and it, again, has sort of those text messages inside. Let's see if I can find one. Oh my god, the titles are really funny. Oh wait, I'm not gonna read that one because that's gonna spoil everything. But like, okay, let's see, like, text messages. Title. Second one is, I wonder who he is. And then the first one is, I lost my phone. They're funny, guys, okay? I give her props for that.